this cow was milked. Bear Rabbit was thirsty. She watched Miss Cow gracefully, peacefully in the meadow. He would love a drink of milk, but how was he to get it? "Howdy, Sis Cow," he said after a while. "Could you do me a little favor, Sis Cow?" Bear Rabbit went on, all big eyes and inconvenience. Miss Cow clearly stopped chewing and looked up at him. "I would dearly love to eat some of those pomegranates," explained Bear Rabbit, pointing to a large tree growing in the meadow. "If you shake the large tree growing in the meadow, if you shake the trunk, then the branches will fall down and we can share them." And now, Miss Cow was a friendly creature and all too happy and obliged. She ran and hit that tree in full tilt. But what a shock! She had got a horn stuck in the tree. Off ran that woolly Bear Rabbit and pretty soon was back with all his little children, and each one carried a clanking milk pail. All the children clustered so tight around Miss Cow that you could hardly see her, and right that very center of them was Bear Rabbit on a three-legged stool, milking away for all he was worth. He filled the pail after pail with the sweet, warm milk, and when he was done, he tipped his hat politely. I realized you might be stuck there all night, and I figured out you'd be pretty sore carrying all that milk. So I thought I'd help you out. Kind of a good deed, you might say. And with that, he set off home. Miss Cow was furious. With one mighty moo, she pawed at the ground and pulled her horn free. Why, she was so mad that Bear Rabbit could almost have sworn he saw a real stream coming from her nostrils. She raced down the meadow after him, and off the field was a large bramble patch, and that lucky rabbit was soon safe inside the bushes. How he laughed! "There isn't one animal I know that can get the better of Brer Rabbit," he boasted happily. Thank you.